Dear colleagues, it's a pleasure for me today to give a presentation on immunotherapy today, integrating the recent achievement that have been observed in advanced HCC. So I will begin my talk by to get back to rationale for immunotherapy. In practice, I think it's important as a medical oncologist to get back to other kind of disease benefiting from immunotherapy to understand why hepatocellular carcinoma has not benefited from single drug using immunotherapy. First, if we look back at the biology of HCC, immune class is reported as representing 24% of cases. And when we look back to the results obtained by using immunotherapy such as nivolumab or pembrolizumab as single agent, we can see that hepatocellular carcinoma range in the low range of response rates in comparison to other diseases such as malignant melanoma or lung cancer. And this is observed regardless of the expression of PD-L1, which is again in the low range of expression in hepatocellular carcinoma. It's in representing 20 to 25% of cases in comparison to other diseases such as malignant melanoma or lung cancer or head and neck cancer, where the PD-L1 expression is really higher. So this could explain, at least in part, the disappointing results that were observed with PD-1 inhibitors, either used in single agent, either in second line versus placebo for pembrolizumab, or versus sorafenib when using nivolumab in first line. So given the fact that single drugs were disappointing, in parallel, combination were explored in advanced HCC, and of course, the major achievement that was reported 2 years ago was the combination of atezolizumab, which is a PD-L1 inhibitor, in combination with bevacizumab as first-line treatment in comparison with sorafenib for advanced hepatocellular carcinoma. I will not get back in detail in these results that you know very well, but this was for the first time an important achievement when combining two monoclonal antibodies in comparison to an oral multikinase inhibitor. This trial was positive for the primary endpoints, including overall survival, but also progression-free survival. And we will get back to that. The response rate was also higher with the combination in comparison to sorafenib. Of note, the tolerance of this combination was also better than the single drug sorafenib, since only 36% of patients receiving the combination were showing adverse events, severe adverse events, in comparison to more than 40% with sorafenib. When we go more in detail in this kind of adverse event, we see also that the incidence, but also the severity of adverse events is lower with the combination. And it is also important to point out that the blood pressure that is increased under the combination is manageable in the clinics, and the type of adverse events are more manageable with the combination than with sorafenib in daily practice. So to summarize this achievement, we can see that combining an approach targeting the vascularization with bevacizumab with the immunotherapy inhibiting PD-L1 with atezolizumab was really something as the best strategy, We should also emphasize as pharmacologists that using monoclonal antibody will optimize the drug exposure in comparison to perus administration, since monoclonal antibody are not influenced by liver metabolism or drug-drug interaction. So basically, this was also important to underline in terms of drug exposure. As you know, the results of the EMBRAVE trial have been updated recently with a median follow-up of 12 additional months. And this has been presented by Dr. Finn at the ASCO GI early this year. So these actualized results are confirming the results that we were observing at the first analysis. And the superiority of the combination is maintained over time at different time points. And the median overall survival with this analysis reaches 19 months as a median in comparison to 30 months with sorafenib. And of course, this difference is highly significant. This is also interesting to get into details in terms of the rate of objective response that have been observed with the combination. As you know, the main drawback of using multikinase inhibitors the recent years were the fact that only a minority and a very limited minority of patients will show an objective response reflecting a tumor shrinkage. This is really different with the combination of atezolizumab and bevacizumab, since, as you see in this table with updated results, at least 30% of the patients treated with the combination will present an objective response by RECIST criteria. That means that 1/3 of the patients will show at least 30% reduction in the diameter of their tumor, which is important to consider in a perspective of earlier stages. In fact, with these results, for the first time, we can think about using a medical approach in terms of downstaging the dimension of a tumor. And this again is very important to consider in the future when considering earlier stage of HCC candidate to local regional therapy. So basically, to summarize the landscape now with immunotherapy, focusing on phase 3 trial ongoing, beyond the EMBRAVE trial, several other trials are exploring other approaches based on immunotherapy, combining immunotherapy with multikinase inhibitor, or combining immunotherapy agent together versus sorafenib in first line. This includes the inhibitor of CTLA-4, and several trials are ongoing or are completed, and the results of this trial will be very important to wait in the next future. Going for earlier stage in terms of adjuvant therapy, at least 2 phase 3 are ongoing using immunotherapy as adjuvant approach after local regional therapy, including nivolumab versus surveillance, or the combination of atezolizumab and bevacizumab versus surveillance in adjuvant setting. And of course, the relapse-free survival will be one of the important primary endpoints. So to summarize what we have using immunotherapy today in HCC, we can say that basically PD-1 inhibitor used as second agent in phase 3 did not reach superiority in terms of overall survival superiority in first line and second line, possibly linked to the weakness of target relevance in the overall population. Conversely, in first line, combining VEGF and PD-L1 inhibition using antibodies has been shown to be superior to the previous standards with oral multikinase inhibitor sorafenib in terms of overall survival, progression-free survival, but also response-based in the EMBRAVE trial. And again, the high rate of objective response by RECIST, which is more than 30% of the patients, will make this new approach very attractive for neoadjuvant or downstaging strategies in this disease. Other immunotherapy agents such as CTLA-4 inhibitors or immunotherapy combined with multikinase inhibitors are actively investigated in first line for advanced HCC. And for the final points, trials are ongoing in the adjuvant setting with immunotherapy, either used as single agent or in combination in this disease. Having said that, I thank you very much for your attention. And this point will be discussed during the discussion. Thank you very much.